Good morning, student. Today class we are discuss about unit number 2 integral calculus. Today class we are discuss about integration by parts. If u and v are two differentiable function of x, then integral over u dv equal to uv minus integral v du. If u and v are two differentiable function of x, then integral u dv equal to uv minus integral v du. We can also choose u as a function which comes first in the word I late. Here I stands for the inverse trigonometric functions. How to choose the u value? We are discuss about how to choose this u value. So use the term I late. I stands for inverse trigonometric functions. I stands for what? Inverse trigonometric function. I means here inverse trigonometric functions. It is included for, that is for inverse trigonometric function means, that is sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, secant inverse, cosecant inverse. That is sine inverse of x, cos inverse of x, tan inverse of x, secant inverse of x, cosecant inverse of x. These are the functions are called inverse trigonometric functions. So I stands for inverse trigonometric function. Next one, L stands for the logarithmic function. L stands for the logarithmic function. L, that is for log x, log x square. So likewise, logarithmic function is given. L stands for the logarithmic function. Next one. So what is the letter? I late. I is a inverse trigonometric function. L for logarithmic function. Next one, A. So what is the letter A? A stands for the algebraic function. That is for x, x square, x cube. These are the algebraic functions. A stands for the algebraic function, x, x square, x cube. These are the functions are called algebraic function. Next one, T stands for the trigonometric function. T stands for the I late. I is the inverse trigonometric function. L for the logarithmic function. A is the algebraic function. Next one, T. This T referred as trigonometric function. Trigonometric function. A, T stands for trigonometric function. That is for sine x, cos x, tan x, cosecant x and cot x. Final letter E. E stands for the exponential function. E stands for the exponential function. That is e power x or e power 2x likewise. So first, how to choose the u value? You remember the term I late. So I late. I denote for the inverse trigonometric function. L denoted for the logarithmic function. A denoted for the algebraic function. T denoted for the trigonometric function. E denoted for the exponential function. Next, we discuss for the Bernoulli's formula. Here Bernoulli's formula. If u and v are the function of x, if u and v are the function of x, then u dv equal to uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus u triple dash v3 plus etc. Where u dash, u double dash, u triple dash are the successive derivative. Derivative means differentiation. U dash, u double dash, u triple dash are the successive derivative of u. And v here V1, V2, V3. V1 and V2 and V3 are the repeated integral of V. V1, V2, V3 are the repeated integral of V. Discuss some exercise problem 2.5. So, exercise 2.5. Integrate the following with respect to x. So, first one, integral x into e power minus x into dx. First, in these three sums, we discussed how to choose the u value. First, we discussed for how to choose the u value. So, here, first, what is the question is? Integral of x into e power minus x into dx. Second one is x cube log x into dx. Third question, x square sine inverse of dx. So, we know the term for I late. We know the term. What is the term? I late. So, first one here, integral x into e power minus x. Now, what is the term I late here? I late. I stands for what? Inverse trigonometric function. So, in this first one, any inverse trigonometric function is there. Here, first one is x is an algebraic function. E power minus x means it is a exponential function. X is a algebraic function. E power minus x is a exponential function. So, I stands for inverse trigonometric function. There is no inverse trigonometric function. Next one, L stands for logarithmic function. Here there is no logarithmic function also. Next one, A stands for algebraic function. A means what? Algebraic function. We already discussed what is algebraic function? X, x square, x cube, likewise. So, A means what? Algebraic function. So, here x is given. X is a algebraic function. So, in this problem, u value equal to x. In this problem, u value equal to x. Next one, we are discussed for second one, how to choose the u value from the second sum. X cube log x. What is the first term? I. I is a inverse trigonometric function. Here, there is any trigonometric function. That is for inverse trigonometric function. Here, there is no sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse. So, next, L. L stands for what? Logarithmic function. See here, log x is given. So, second problem, u equal to log x. See the first problem, we are choosing u value is x. And in this problem, you can choose I is a inverse trigonometric function. There is no inverse trigonometric functions in this question. Next one, you can choose for L. L is a logarithmic function. Log x is given. So, choosing u value equal to log x. See here, in this problem, third one, integral of x square into sine inverse of x. X square into sine inverse of x. So, what is the first one term? We know that I late. I stands for inverse trigonometric function. Here, sine u equal to what? Sine inverse of x. E equal to what? Sine inverse of x. Because I is the inverse trigonometric function. Likewise, you can choose in this problem, what are the, how to choose for the u value? How to choose the u value? Remember the term I late. I stands for inverse trigonometric function. L stands for the logarithmic function. A stands for algebraic function. T stands for the trigonometric function. E stands for the exponential function. Likewise, you can choose the u value. Next, we discuss the how to solve these problems. Exercise 2.5. Integrate the following with respect to x. First question, integral of x into e power minus x into dx. We know the term for I late. I denoted for the inverse trigonometric functions. Here there is no inverse trigonometric functions. That is sine inverse, cos inverse. There is no term. Next one, L. L stands for the logarithmic function. In this question, there is no logarithmic function also. A stands for the algebraic function. Algebraic function means x, x square, x cube, likewise. So here x is given. So you can choose the value for u equal to x. U equal to x. So we are using the Bernoulli's formula only. We are solving the problem. So u equal to x. So what is the Bernoulli's formula? First we'll learn about Bernoulli's formula means integral u dv equal to integral u dv equal to uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus u triple dash v3 plus etc. Integral u dv equal to uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus u triple dash v3 plus etc. So u equal to what? U equal to we are choosing the value for x. How we are choosing for this value? I stands for the inverse trigonometric function, L for the logarithmic function, A is the algebraic function. So you can choose the value for u equal to x. U equal to x. Now find out the derivative. Derivative for x is 1. What is the derivative for x? We are not integrating, we are differentiating the given function. Differentiation for x is 1. U dash, it is denoted for u dash equal to 1. Next one, u double dash. Here 1 is the constant term. 1 is a constant term. So derivative of the constant term is 0. Derivative of the constant term is 0. We are choosing u equal to x, u dash equal to 1. Differentiation formula, derivative for x is 1. Next one, u double dash, derivative for 1 is 0. Next u triple dash also 0 only, because derivative of 0 is 0 only. So next remaining term u double triple dash u4 also 0 only. So you can get 0 means you can stop here. U double dash equal to 0. So now find out for the next one, integral dv. So what is the Bernoulli's formula? Integral u dv. We are choosing u value, find out the value for u, u dash, u double dash, up to the term 0. Next one, what is the remaining term? Integral dv. So integral dv here, integral dv. We are already choose the value for u value. What is the remaining term? Integral e power minus x into dx. Integral e power minus x into dx. So integration for dv, integral. Now we are integrating the given function. Integral for dv is v. Integral of e power minus x is e power minus x. What is the coefficient of x here? Minus 1. So write that coefficient value in the denominator, minus 1. So integral of e power minus x is e power minus x divided by minus 1. Finally we get for minus e power minus x. Now once again you can integrate the given function v1 equal to, because up to u dash we know the value, so you can find out the value for v1. Here u double dash you can get 2 or 3 some other value, means you can find out also v2 value. So you can, v value is minus e power minus x. V1, once again you can integrate the given function. Minus is already is there. Integral for the e power minus x is e power minus x divided by minus 1. Now minus into minus plus 1. So we get the value for e power minus x. Okay. Next one, apply the Bernoulli's formula. Integral u dv equal to uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus u triple dash v3 plus etc. Because here v1 is term is there. U double dash, what is the value? U double dash is 0. So no need to find out the value for v2. That is why we are not finding the value for v2. Here u double dash, what is the value? U double dash is 0. You are substituting here 0 mean 0 into here any other value also 0 only. So no need to find out the value for v2 value. So integral u dv, u value is x, integral dv value is e power minus x into dx. What is the u value? U value is what? X. U value is x. Substitute the value. U value is x. X. Next one, v. What is the v value? Minus of e power minus x. So minus of u value is x, v value is minus e power minus x, minus x, minus of u dash value is, what is the u dash value? U dash value is 1, u dash value is 1, and v1 value is e power minus x, plus what is the u double dash value? U double dash value is 0, u double dash value is 0. So next one, so there is 0, so v2, that is why we are not finding out the value for v2 value. Here 0 into any other term, 0 only. So now next, simplify this one, minus x into e power minus x, minus e power minus x, here some integral constant plus c. From this two term here, what are the two term here? Minus x e power minus x, minus e power minus x. Here e power minus x, here also e power minus x is a common term. So take common out, remaining term minus x minus 1, minus x minus 1, here plus c. C is a integral constant. Thank you, student.